Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today in this video, we are going to talk about how to use a double point tracker in HitFilm Express. So if you have not seen my absolute beginner's lesson on single point tracking, I'm going to leave a link in the description below and a card up above on to the right hand side. And I would like for you to go and watch that video first before you watch this one, then come back and watch this one. The double point tracker is extremely easy to use and very effective tool. I am going to take this video of my office door that I created, drag it onto the editor timeline, and you can see if I were to scrub through it that I have placed a couple of tracking markers. These literally were sticky notes that I put a big X on, and I want to track those and put a piece of text on this door. So I'm going to right click on this and make it into a composite shot, and clicking OK, I have this video footage now in its own composite shot. If I open this properties and click on Insert Tracker in the very first item, which is Tracks, then you'll see that it has added a tracking marker here, and it has moved me from the Viewer tab into the Layer tab. If you look over here in the Control Panel, you'll see under the Track tab, Step 1, track your points, and it is a single point position only track. What we're going to do is I'm going to click on this and make it a double point track. And now you can see I have 2 points here that I am able to track. And if I use my mouse wheel, I can zoom in on this a little bit, and I can grab each one of these and move them. Using my right mouse click, I can drag myself over a little bit, and I can just grab and place this, left clicking, of course, here. Zooming in a little bit more, you can always adjust the sizes of these boxes, but this red box is what it is looking for, and this green box is the area in which it is looking for that. So I'll make this nice and small so that it knows exactly what I want it to see. Now I'm going to come over to the other side, and we will place the second box over the second tracking marker, again making some adjustments here to ensure that I am going to get a good track. Now if I go scale to fit, I am ready to do the tracking, and so I can go ahead and hit the track forward button under the track tab and let HitFilm go ahead and do its thing as far as tracking this scene. Now you can see that it is actually recording the data for both of those tracking points, and we have a very clean track, never slid off or anything like that. Perfect, in fact. So now, if I look here, you see that it says it has recorded the X and the Y position, but it has also recorded all of the information to calculate the rotation and the scale. So what I am going to do is I'm going to add a new layer. It will be a point layer. And when I do this, the screen will turn black. The reason is because we're still under the Layer tab. This throws a lot of people. So make sure that after you do this, or before you do this even, you click the Viewer tab to see the entire layer stack of everything that's in here. Now that new point is sitting right there, but if I go back into the door video footage and I go ahead and select the rotation and the scale, and then I assign it to that new point layer and click apply, then it will automatically place the point on the first tracker and it is moving through there. Now you're asking yourself, what are all these white dots? These white dots are simply the motion path, and it's showing you how the motion of this point is happening. And you can turn that off just by clicking here on the show motion path icon if you like. If I open up the transform properties of the new point, you can see that the data has been recorded here in terms of position, but also relative to the other point in terms of rotation, as you see, if I scrub through this, you can see that the rotation has moved a little bit. And also the scale, if this is 100, then as I moved in, all of a sudden now we're at 142 because they have gotten further apart from each other in the frame, which indicates that my camera moved towards the two of those things. So now, if I want, I could add a text layer, and I will just type in the letters TEXT, text. And if I use the selection tool and go into the text tab, I can make some adjustments to that. And I think I will. We'll just place this directly in between. And now, if I were to parent this text to that new point, it will take on all of the characteristics of that new point. So as the new point rotates, the text rotates. As the new point scales up, the text scales up as well. So this sort of makes it look as if that is actually attached to that door itself as I am playing, which is pretty cool, right? Now, I know what you're thinking next, and that is you're thinking, well, how I don't want these tracking markers in my shot itself, but that's okay because using a effect called the clone stamp tool, you can remove those tracking markers, and I will be showing you how to do that in a future lesson. So if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. If you like this kind of information or these kinds of tutorials, please do me a favor and like this video, subscribe to the channel, share it with your friends, that sort of thing. And as always, thanks for watching.